It's running. Greetings in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Welcome to the Christmas circus this morning. I promise you, when I put together the script for this, I thought simple, but it's been like that snowball going downhill, which is a lot of fun. This is one of those mornings when anything could happen. Those are my favorite kinds of days. We've got at least a dozen angels all revved up already. And I'm trying to hold their interest until time for the play to begin. In the meantime, of course, we want to gather together to praise God and to pray together. The presentation this morning is part of our theory about Christian education that we've used here for a long time. We tell the same story for a month from the Bible. It's been the Christmas story for November. And the first 3 weeks, we try to tell the children in a different way. We act it out, we present it, we tell it. And then the last week, we ask the children to tell us the story back. And that's what they're going to do today. The children will tell us the story today. You're going to get to look behind the scenes a little bit because of our new video capability here. And so while we tell the story that they heard at Sunday school, you'll see some video of the children while they worked on what they have to present to you today. And then there'll be a few surprises for all of us, I'm sure, as we go along.
So guys, we get
in prayer together. Would you bow your head? Lord, as we gather, we pray for this house, that it may truly be a place of meeting in warmth and joy and openness, meeting in courage and love and trust. And may all of us who enter here trust one another so surely that we may share the deep fires that burst into anger as much as the sweet spring waters that swell into laughter, the slow erosion of wounded tears as much as the soaring of joy. May these walls know silence as 100 hearts search inward each for its own small spark of hope that might otherwise be snuffed out in the noise. And may these rafters hear the voice of children as surely as that of the order and those who will sing, and a stirring congregation as well as children who are marching in all the wrong directions and full of joy, as much as the shout of a million stars. May we meet you through yourself in this place, O Lord. Inhabit this room in our hearts and bless us with joy and peace. Amen. We have some announcements to make. I know is Penny going to come and share while she comes. I'll announce it regarding the Sunday school program. I want to say a word of acknowledgement to Rachel Lakeland, who's done a fabulous job of recruiting volunteers for the past 4 months since we made our meeting. Because of that, we decided that the most popular route with our parents is to have a concurrent children's church, and so that will begin in January, concurrent with our 10 a.m. worship. We're going to go back to that sort of format. We've had wonderful volunteers. I'm looking at Rich Kenny, who's been my right-hand man for the last 4 months. I said I wanted a man Sunday school teacher, and he's been a great help, and I appreciate that too. And all the volunteers who have shown up today to be stage directors this morning. When I wrote this, I said it was simple, but it's become something much more. Please come ahead, Kenny.
Is in hospice and is failing. And so he got the help from Judith that she needed help. And so he had to go up to the room this morning.
Can I hear Mark?
Yeah. We can hear you.
We can hear you.
All right, I'm going to start again.
Okay, our sound guy is back. Jack would be here with us today, but he got a call from his wife. His mother-in-law, Judith has been staying with her mother, who is failing. She's in hospice. And he got a call from Judith to please come and help. So he left early this morning to do that. So please keep Lillian Wasser in your prayers. That's Judith's mother. Today is the last day to order poinsettias for the altar. The forms are in the north exit, and it's $10. If you have someone that you would like to remember or honor, think about that. This Tuesday is our monthly council meeting at 6:30. We're going to have a busy church night on Tuesday. The Learning Center has their annual Christmas program in the sanctuary, and then they're going to have a little fellowship time in the hall. So we're going to be having a council meeting in the conference room. To let you know that our church family, through their amazing generosity, raised $6,200 for the Peace Pantry, the families of the Peace Pantry, when we have the program where they're able to go to Walmart and pick out their own gifts. So thank you very much for your kindness and your generosity. Another thank you, and this one is to both our youth group and to our scout troop. They volunteered on Friday evening to help clean up after the frenzy of activity that is the annual Foster Children's holiday party. And so it's having been involved in that event, it takes a lot of volunteers to make it happen and to clean up after it. So thank you to the youth and the scouts, to Shauna for mobilizing the scouts, and to Terry for mobilizing our youth. The land sale with the Schraders is finally done. The closing happened this week. Jack Nobles and Ruth Ann were there, and the check's already in the bank, so woohoo! And I just want to take a brief minute. I know that we just had a fundraising campaign for local families who have needs, but this is also a time of the year where the United Church of Christ has a special offering. It's called the Christmas Fund for the Veterans of the Cross. Not every church has land giving to a pension plan for their pastor. We do here at St. Martin's, but there are many churches, smaller churches, that don't. So this special offering lets us join with other churches in the denomination for an emergency fund for retired pastors who might have low income or have emergencies. It can supplement small annuities. It can help with health premium payments, and also provide emergency grants. And it's a way to bring good news and great joy to those who have given so much to the churches of our denomination. So if you're interested in making a donation, you can mark an envelope with UCC Christmas Fund. And that's all. I'm very excited about the program, and I want to repeat what the pastor says. Having been a counselor for a number of years, we talk all the time about how we can get folks to work with different programs here, and thank you to everybody who stepped up and worked with this children's program and is involved in the presentation today.
They're all busy keeping the children entertained right now, so we're going to make haste. Who has a birthday to celebrate this week? My notes say Mark Dickerson has a birthday. Donna Guinea has a birthday this week. Should I ask how many?
The big 7-0
with a 0-8. Mike Williams has a birthday this week. Our son Daniel has a birthday this week. 38. Oh my word. Are there other birthdays or anniversaries to celebrate? Yes?
I have an anniversary.
An anniversary. How many years?
44.
Congratulations. 44 years. Let's sing happy birthday together, Mike. And happy anniversary. Mm-hmm. I'm going to go back and hang on. You're going to lead it out to heaven.
Anniversary to you. Happy anniversary to you. Happy anniversary, God bless you. Happy anniversary to you.
Oh, it's better. Much better. Much better. Let's bring it into the hand of God. Scripture lesson.
Today we light three candles. The first candle
is the candle of hope. During Advent, we wait in the hope of God's promises will be fulfilled. The second candle is the candle of peace. We can have peace because God's preparations brought forth the fulfillment of the promises. Today's candle is the candle of joy. God has given us the gift of salvation. Let us rejoice. Let us pray. Gracious Lord, as we wait during Advent for the coming of your Son, fill our lives with joy. Fill us with joy because we will benefit from the gift of salvation. Fill us with joy at the coming of your Son. Fill us with joy as we serve a world that needs the joy that comes from knowing Jesus Christ.
Come to our time of prayer. We want to certainly remember all those victims of the treacherous weather this week, and many who perished in Kentucky and Illinois nearby. This week, Bob Dole was put to rest, and several folks have said it marks the end of a different kind of era where the politicians argued all day but still were friends at night. And we pray for God to help us to return to those kind of civil times. And then also, we want to remember in our prayers Jude Roberts, who has an outpatient surgery this week. Sandy Rowland's family at the passing of her brother Steve this week. We want to hold our prayers to Carol Fitzpatrick, who began hospice care this week. Are there other joys or concerns to share? Yes.
Betty Hawk's knee surgery.
Oh, yes, Betty Hawk has a procedure, a knee procedure. Yes, you had to get it.
Yes, my brother-in-law, Joe
Heinker,
has been in the hospital since Monday.
Prayers for your brother-in-law in hospital. Yes, Marcia, did you have that? Others? Yes, here.
My son, Anthony Nelson, was in a car accident, and he got the report from the doctor on Friday. And it's okay, but it's not great, and then he has to go for an additional MRI because they found something on a mass on his neck.
Hold your son again, thinking our prayers in the car with us. Yes,
and I think we should pray for Judy Davis, who had surgery this past week.
Judy Davis, who had surgery this week, also. Yes. Let's bow our heads together. Lord, you are the God of stars and stables and angels and shepherds, and we celebrate your name for the gift of the Christ child. And we will sing your praises for your humbly dwelling among men and women of the world. Give us hearts filled with your presence, that we may be changed from children of darkness into children of light. Teach our tongues to speak of your greatness, that all our households may reflect your glory. Bring hope and love and joy into our midst, that we may share with all the world the faith that moves mountains and the belief that banishes sorrow. Anoint our sick with the confidence that says, whether I live or whether I die, I am the Lord's. Surround our children with care and protection, that they may grow up in grace and goodness. Show us how to live in peace and fullness with one another, sharing what we have with the poor and the humble. Enable us to give as you did, without assessing the cost, to love sacrificially without counting the cost. Let us give thanks with all our hearts for the real message of Christmas, that you have come among us today in order that we may live with you forever, through the one who was born in Bethlehem, who is Jesus Christ, our Savior, who taught us to pray together whenever we pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed
be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
The scripture reading this morning is Isaiah chapter 11, verses 1 through 6. A shoot will come up from the stump of Jesse. From his roots, a branch will bear fruit. The Spirit of the Lord will rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and of understanding, the Spirit of counsel and of might, the Spirit of the knowledge and fear of the Lord. And he will delight in the fear of the Lord. He will not judge by what he sees with his eyes, or decide by what he hears with his ears. But with righteousness he will judge the needy. With justice he will give decisions for the poor of the earth. He will strike the earth with the rod of his mouth. With the breath of his lips he will slay the wicked. Righteousness will be his belt, and faithfulness the sash around his waist. The wolf will live with the lamb. The leopard will lie down with the goat, the calf and the lion and the yearlings together, and the little child will lead them. Would you all stand for the Apostles' Creed? I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only begotten Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended to hell. On the third day he arose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and stood on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the one holy universal Christian Church, the communion of the saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Thank you.
Okay, rallying the troops. The children are going to tell us the story of Christmas in four grand processions. And so let us begin. We begin with the story of God's angels. Because they are such a significant part of the story of Christmas, an angel announced to Mary that she was going to become the mother of the Christ child. Luke says during Elizabeth's 6 months of pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin. She was engaged to marry a man named Joseph from the family of David. Her name was Mary. The angel came to her and said, "Greetings. The Lord has blessed you and is with you." But Mary was very startled by what the angel said and wondered what this greeting might mean. The angel said to her, "Don't be afraid, Mary. God has shown you his grace. Listen, you will become pregnant and give birth to a son. You will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of King David, his ancestor. He will rule over the people of Jacob forever, and his kingdom will never end." Mary said, "I am the servant of the Lord. Let this happen to me as you say." And then the angel went away. The angels made the announcement of the good news to the shepherds in their fields. Luke says, "The angel said to them, 'Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord.'" Angels are God's special messengers, and the Bible tells us that they will be there in full force when we see them in heaven. The book of Revelation says, "Then I looked and heard the voice of many angels, numbering thousands upon thousands and 10,000 times 10,000. They encircled the throne and the living creatures and the elders. In a loud voice they were saying, 'Worthy is the Lamb who was slain to receive power and wealth and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and praise.' Then I heard every creature in heaven and on earth and under the earth and on the sea and all that is in them, saying, 'To him who sits on the throne and to the Lamb be praise and honor and glory and power, now and forever.'"
Record.
shepherds are chomping at the bit. First, I want to tell the story, and then during the next carol, we're going to, they've been waiting to herd these sheep for weeks, guys. But first, I want to tell the story of the shepherds while we watch the video. Shepherds have been a major part of the biblical story almost from the very beginning. Moses, who led God's people out of Egypt and to the promised land, was a shepherd. Jacob, whose name became Israel, and who was the father of all the tribes of Israel, and served his father-in-law Laban, was a shepherd. David was tending sheep when the prophet Samuel called upon him to anoint him king. But also the scriptures tell us that Jesus is the good shepherd who cares for each of us like we are members of his own flock. The night that Jesus was born, it only seemed fitting then, but the first was to hear the news where the shepherds who were tending sheep by night. Luke says, suddenly a great company of the heavenly host appeared to the shepherds, tending the flocks nearby. The angels were praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those who have found his favor. When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about. So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and baby Jesus, who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. Many years ago, candy maker who wanted to make a candy that would be a reminder to the children about Jesus Christ and that he was the good shepherd of God's sheep, made a candy cane. The canes were made in the shape of the letter J, which represented the name of Jesus, and the staff of the good shepherd. Who came You're okay to leave and do something. The writing that came from four places, it's a message to us about the world coming to Jesus, and also a gift which the three kings bring. Can be a symbol to us of the reason that all of us love to give and receive gifts at this time of year in the first place. May all of our giving and receiving this holy season remind us of the greatest gift of all, Jesus, the Son of God. This is what the Bible tells us about the visit of the wise men who followed the star to find the baby Jesus. Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea. This happened while Herod was king of Judea. After Jesus' birth, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem. They asked, "Where is the child who was born to be the king of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose, and now we have come to worship him." When King Herod heard about it, he was very upset. Everyone in Jerusalem was troubled also. So Herod called together all the chief priests of the people, who also called the teachers of the law. He asked them where the Messiah was going to be born. "In Bethlehem of Judea," they replied. "This is what the prophet wrote about when he said, 'But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are certainly not the least important among the towns of Judah. A ruler will come out of you. He will rule my people Israel like a shepherd.'" Then Herod secretly called for the wise men. He found out from them exactly when the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem, and he said, "Go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report it to me, that I can go and worship him too." After the wise men had listened to the king, they went on their way. The star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them, and finally stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were filled with joy. The wise men went to the house. There they saw the child with his mother Mary. They bowed down and worshipped him. And then they opened their treasures. They gave him gold and frankincense and myrrh. But God warned them in a dream not to go back to Herod, so they returned to their country by another way.
Star of light, star of night, star
Finally then, this is a story about the birth of a baby after all, and that is properly welcomed with joy and anticipation and lots of love. The fact that the great and mighty God of heaven will choose to be revealed to us as a child reminds us to cherish and nurture all of the children given to our care as a matter of greatest importance. This must be precisely what the prophet Isaiah meant when he foretold the acceptable day of the Lord, saying, "The wolf shall dwell with the lamb, the leopard shall lie down with the young goat, the calf and the young lion and fatling together, and a child shall lead them." The treasured gospel story of the birth of the baby Jesus says, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria. Everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went out from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and lineage of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available to them. Make room for Jesus in your hearts today. Leave room to honor Jesus' birth in your Christmas celebration with family and friends, but also make some noise because we are come to praise God for the gift of our Savior, who is Christ the Lord. Amen. God and the children made baby rattles for this lesson. They want to share some noise makers with you too. Little sheep, we pray that you will watch over us, that you protect us, that you will guide us, that you be the one who gives your life for us and for our protection and our welfare. And we promise to be faithful sheep of your flock and not to go astray, but to follow this Jesus if we have made that faith in our name. Amen. 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 We're going to dedicate our tithes and offerings. Thanks, God. Thank you. Thank you. Shall we dedicate our prayer? Praise him for his surpassing greatness.
Praise him for his surpassing greatness.
Praise him with the sound of trumpets.
Praise him with the sound of trumpets.
Praise him with the harp and lyre.
Praise him with the harp and lyre.
Praise him with the timbrel and dancing.
Praise him with the timbrel and dancing.
And shake it one more time with the air. Yeah. Praise him with the strings and the pipe.
Praise him with the strings and the pipe.
With everything that has breath.
With everything that has breath.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And praise the Lord.
We could go on all day. Amen. God bless you. And we go our separate ways.